Yeah, for sure. I want to switch gears a little bit because, like you said, I mean, again, the adversity that you battled, Syvelle, some of it's very well – a lot of it's very well documented. A lot of it's not. There was an article put out, Watch Fox did, a good buddy of mine, Mike Yuva, who we just had on the show last week. This story was published in May, just talking about – I've seen you go live with Ryan Helinski with his Helinski's Hope stuff, talking about mental health and stuff like that. And, again, you dealt with a ton of injuries, and maybe your professional career didn't exactly go the way you planned, for sure. But just talk about, I guess, how it's made you better as a person. Because, like you said, even since the last time we've talked, I can definitely tell – your whole mentality and mindset and view on things has changed, I think, for the better. But just talk about, you know, again, a lot of what's highlighted in this article, where you were. You know, it talks about the death of Kenny McKinley, which you all remember, and that was a really good friend of yours and a teammate. And, again, just changing the entire mindset. I mean, you became the owner of BU4U, Love Yourself, LLC, which is a business that does counseling, counseling for kids and stuff like that. So just overall, I know it's a lot to unpack, but just talk about that, the changes in your life and overall your mental health and how everything's just changed for the better for you.
Well, I mean, with me, it was more just finding myself, man, outside of sports, finding myself outside of feeling like maybe a failure at being at something that I knew I was actually good at. Anytime you chasing something, you chasing what I would call what you think is your purpose. And once you don't fulfill that purpose that you think is your purpose, it causes mental issues. And it don't have to be football. It don't have to be sports. It could be anything. You know, it could be someone fighting to be a doctor or be a lawyer or anything. If they don't become that and they just knew that's what in their heart, like that's what they're supposed to be, they gonna have struggles. And that's where I was, and you know, still kind of, you know, torn about how some of the things had went on at South Carolina. That's why I've always had like a kind of chip on my shoulder when it always came to discussing Carolina and talking about would I go back and do this and my love for the school and everything. So it's been like a love and hate relationship. But now, you know, just to be in a different place after, you know, battling anxiety and depression and being at a position where, you know, like I said, even at one point where I was sleeping in my car, you know, so to be at that position to look back and say, you know, like, man, like, what are you doing? And to be in counseling, going to counseling twice a week. And it was tough, you know, it was tough. And I fought until I figured out that just what the business says right now, be you for you, love yourself, that's basically, you know, what I pretty much go out and talk about right now. And I had to practice that. And it was a total life change for me. I went back and rewrote some of those things. I changed the narrative on, you know, my beef with Coach Spurry. I changed the narrative on my beef with Carolina. I changed the narrative on, you know, feeling like I failed my family or anything like that, or I failed myself. So all the narratives have been changed and rewritten, and I'm still rewriting my story every day, man. And just to be in this position now, this is what I think a lot of universities are missing. They're missing those who have fought true adversity to be around these guys, to have them ready for adversity, you know, because it's going to be a lot of hurt people that's not going to really, you know, be able to express them, show themselves, like show, make themselves known to get an NFL shot due to what, you know, what we're going through right now. So, you know, some of those guys are going to fight, you know, mentally and emotionally, because they're going to feel cheated out of something. But if you got things in line in preparation for that already, which I think Marcus did a great job while he was there. And I hope Connor also does a great job while he's there also, because he fought some adversity. But just if you're not prepared mentally, man, like you will struggle in life, and that's my whole key to everything I do. And that's why I love Ryan so much, man. Mm-hmm. He's a dope guy, man. I mean, no matter his struggles on the field as a freshman, being thrown into the toughest, you know, schedule, which is still football. You still have to show up. I'm not going to make an excuse for him. But, you know, it is what he and his family went through, and being able to bring that hope and that everything that they're doing to this community here in Gamecock football is amazing, man.
For sure. No, that's awesome, man. I can speak. I know I can say I'm glad as your friend to hear all that. I mean, for sure. You got a lot of positive stuff going on, a lot of people in your life that love you too. So, I mean, for sure. Oh, yeah.